catch in the lay-in from Palmer. Lions with six. 5:15 left to play in the third. 78-66 Toros. We'll have a timeout, next dead ball. Walker looking down low for Hadley. Instead gives to Bobbitt. Bobbitt on the drive to Antoine Walker. 4-3, and it's good. Antoine Walker hits the triple. His second three of the game. He's got 10. Inside 5 minutes to play in the third. 78-69 Toros, the lead in the ball. Aubrey Coleman guarded by Bobbitt. Gets by him, shoots a long two. It's off. Rebound Karam's right. Palmer's got it. Goes up and scores right around Babbitt. Kevin Palmer's got 13. '80-69. Toros by 11. Idaho with possession. Antoine Walker palming it with his left hand. Still holding it. Guarded by Kuzan. Lob pass down low. Hadley. Shot is blocked by Palmer. Here come the Toros with numbers. 5-on-3. It's Lions to the rack, and he's fouled. And we have a technical foul on Tony Bobbitt, who never even made it into the front court. Timeout on the floor. The Austin Toros by 11, 80-69. Back in 2 minutes on the D-League Radio Network. NBA Green Week going on through April 2nd. For more information on how you can get involved, log on to nbacares.com/green. Players for teams throughout the NBA Development League wearing green and white warm-up jerseys. Draw attention to all issues concerning the environment. Palmer hits the technical foul. Again, nbacares.com/green. Toros did wear some green jerseys yesterday, camouflage jerseys, on Military Appreciation Day. Lions misses the free throw here. He'll shoot one more. Randy Livingston, head coach of the Idaho Stampede, sitting down on the bench now with some instructions. Second free throw for Lions is good, so he splits the pair. Leo has 7 in the game in 22 minutes, and the Toros lead at 82-69. 13-point advantage. They've led by as many as 14. Cedric Jackson bounced past to Hadley, and Hadley's foot was on the sideline. A turnover on Idaho. 12th turnover of the game. The attendance tonight at Cedar Park Center, 2,494. Following a great crowd yesterday on Military Appreciation Day. We're inside 4 minutes to play in the third. Joyner back to the basket, now faces up. He's way outside of the three-point line, hands it off to Squeak. Squeaky between his legs on the dribble, looking for the cutter, Palmer. Instead gives to Weaver. Weaver left wing, up top Squeaky with three. Now with two, Squeaky step back, has to force one up. It's off, and the rebound taken by Babbitt. They say a shot clock violation. .333 left to play in the third. Cedric Jackson to walk it up. Luke Babbitt above the right elbow, guarded by Joyner in the man-to-man. Cross court to Bobbitt. Bobbitt with a stop-and-go dribble on Weaver to Babbitt. Luke Babbitt drives left of the lane, puts it up off the window and scores. The Trailblazers assignee has 16 in the game. Squeaky runs it back, gives to Palmer, blows by Hadley, who scores and give him a free throw. Tough shot by Kevin Palmer, and he gets it to drop. Palmer's got 16, four above his average. And the Toros lead it by 13 once again with Palmer going to the line. Trey Kelly will check in momentarily. He's in for Squeaky Johnson. Toro's bench has given them some good production today. 6 for Joyner, 16 for Palmer, 7 for Kelly. Boateng with 4. So that is 33 bench points. Meantime, the Stampede with 22 bench points. Palmer's free throw is good. 17 now for Kevin Palmer. Babbitt at the three-point line. Luke against Joyner. Pull up, 17-footer. In and out, the rebound. Kevin Palmer. Palmer up ahead to Weaver. Center of the floor. Winds out along the right side. Guarded by Bobbitt. Gives to Boateng out near the logo. Couple of dribbles. Handoff dribble to Kelly. Kelly with 12 to Joyner. Lobs it for Boateng and threw it over Boateng, but a foul on Wheeler. And we should have our media timeout. First dead ball under 3 minutes. We do. 2:36 left to play in the quarter. It's the Toros by 14, 85-71. From Cedar Park Center here along the D-League Radio Network.
Color on the page. Come see how it really gets done and why you should print with us.
Late third quarter here at the Cedar Park Center, just north of Austin. Toros leading the Stampede by 14. And Carlos Wheeler has been ejected from the game with two technical fouls. So Palmer at the line. Palmer making a living at the free throw line on technical fouls today. KP's got 18. Make it 19. So I'm showing four technical fouls on Idaho today. Walker, Bobbitt, and two on Wheeler. And now Boateng at the line. Toros have the largest lead of the game at 16. We've had six ties in this one, seven lead changes. Points in the paint, 34-26 Toros. Remember, Toros got hammered in that department in Saturday's loss. Second chance points, 10-9 Stampede. Fast break points, 14-9 Toros. Boateng misses the second free throw. And out of bounds, touch last by Idaho. So Toros have their largest lead of the game at 16. And a fresh shot clock. Toros outscoring the Stampede 26-18 here in the third. Palmer bounced past to Boateng, low and left. Turns faces up to the cutting Joyner, went through his hands. Touched last by Idaho. Five out there for Austin. Trey Kelly, Kevin Palmer, Eric Boateng, Kyle Weaver, and Michael Joyner. Inbounds to Boateng with 12. Boateng, left wing, needs some help. Waiting for a guard to come over. Cross court to Palmer with 7 against Babbitt. Tries to drive. Palmer got away with the carry there. Loses his footing. Scooped up by Banks. And here comes the Stampede. Babbitt, center of the floor. Bounce pass up ahead. Jenkins, reverse layup. Good. Babbitt the assist. Jenkins the lay-in. And the lead is 14 for the Toros. Trey Kelly. Laterally to his left. Lobs for Boateng. Low and right. Boateng traveled with the basketball. No, they got an offensive foul. Could have had a travel. And then they got the offensive foul on Boateng trying to run over the defender. Second personal on Boateng. Cedric Jackson in the front court. Much different game for him compared to yesterday. He's got 3 points, 9 assists, 2 rebounds. He had 25 in the victory yesterday. Straightaway three. No good from Willie Jenkins in the rebounds. To Kevin Palmer. Palmer, 19 points, 7 rebounds for the Toros. Leading the Toros in rebounds. Joyner hands it off to Weaver. Offensive foul. Joyner setting a screen. That's 4 on Joyner. Minute 21 left to play in the third. Toros still lead it by 14, but not much rhythm to this third quarter for either team. Cedric Jackson gets a screen from Banks. Dribbles to his right. Jackson down the lane. Jackson throws it away. He's trying to throw it out high. Palmer races out 2-on-2. Palmer to the rack. His layup is good. 21 for Kevin Palmer. 89-73. Toros by 16. Inside a minute to play in the third. Babbitt slashing in from the right. Goes reverse side and scores. Babbitt. At 6'9", can really elevate. He's got 18 points in the game, one below his average. Trey Kelly, the right-handed dribble, out near the logo. Kelly to his left, picks up his dribble, gives to Joyner. Straightaway three is no good. And Jenkins high above everyone for the rebound. Bobbitt into the front court, throws the lob alley-oop for Banks. Tough adjustment. Couldn't get her to go, but he did draw a foul. 26 seconds left in the third. Foul on the Toros. This is on Joyner. It's number five on Michael Joyner. Kevin Palmer's season high is 24 points. He's got 21 right now. Free throw no good for Sean Banks. Stampede, 10 of 15 shooting free throws, 66%. The Toros are 24 of 29, 83%. Teams identical field goal shooting percentage right now. Toros 29 of 58, Stampede 29 of 58. Banks hit the second free throw. The lead is 13 for the Toros. About a 1 second difference between shot clock and the game clock. Kyle Weaver, guard out of Washington State, has the dribble for the Toros straight down the lane. Got bumped, no whistle, and he banked it home. Now Bobbitt runs it up with four and with three. Stop and pop for three. It's off. Banks the rebound. Did not get the shot off, and that's going to do it for the third. Nice drive by Weaver to extend the Toros' lead to 15 entering the fourth. After three quarters, it's the Austin Toros 91, the Idaho Stampede 76. Live from the Cedar Park Center, you're listening to the D-League Radio Network.